Alright, in excitement, I found a new technique because I've been like desperate for filigree. I can't believe how much I want the filigree on like these simple. This is like a simple faux. Here's a cupboard, you know, and I'm trying to make it over, make it marbleize. It's the beginning of it. It's got the base coat and then the sponge, and then after all of that, you draw the marble and then accent it a little more. But the whole time I'm like, well, who cares about all this? I want it to look like Pompeii. And so with Pompeii, I went with Andrea. I went with the string. I have a lot of pretty satin string. And so then I use a wallpaper paste. Now, very important, I used the glue and it was a terrible experience. It would not adhere fast enough. So you use a wallpaper paste. And you go along the edge. I'm gonna put a photo there on the front. You go along the edge, the inside edge, because these are the most horrible things that they put out all over the place. But yeah, you go along the edge with the string, and then it stays there. You lock it in place with what do we call it? It's still wet. There's something you adhere it with. A brush, and then you make the curls. Do you understand? So then the filigree itself, you can start to make funny curls and shapes. So it's like wire. So it has a wire effect. And then after all of this is done, you can go back and you can paint it. I used the gold. I had gold thread, gold satin thread, but. When you put that sealer on top of it, that polyurethane type sealer, it disappears. You lose that gold sheen, so you don't have as much of it. So you actually end up having to go back and paint it. And once you paint it, then the sheen of the paint is there. So it's a very nice effect, but you do have to go and paint it. But it all works with the distress look. Of a distressed Pompeii. And so here it is. And so I'm making filigrees all around, and the wallpaper paste is sticking to, and then at the end of it, after you're happy with where it goes, after it's dried, then you coat it, you paint it any color you want, this string, fat roll string it is, and then after it's painted, you can seal it. You can seal it, I think maybe twice will do it, but it's a very nice effect. It just looks like really thick, heavy gauge copper wire. And you can put it around also. I'm not finished. The picture I'm showing is not finished of it, but at the very edge, you see here, because there's like a moment where there's nothing and it's just boring. And all these people are trying to antique everything, aren't they? Antique this, antique that, and you put in those washes. Well, this is another way of doing it, is just adding the accent, you see? And so when it is straight and it's tight, it makes like a ribbon effect all the way around. But yet it gets sealed into the board. So it's kind of exciting. It's very exciting. And it's called the decoupage with the fabric. So yeah, just another way to go. But this technique, I'm only at the beginning of it. I've done this bladder of the sponge, regular sponge, not sea. And then I don't even know, want to comment about the sea sponge issue. That's probably terrible for the planet also. But then after all of that, then you draw. You take a little lines and you just draw them all over and pretend you're marble, and then stipple around on either side and give accents to it, and then there it is, and then there you have marble, and then poly it up. So poly on a cracker. But yeah, this is the coolest technique ever. The string with wallpaper paste, and you can use it for on canvas, you can use it now in the kitchen, you can use it everywhere. I'm just thrilled because I wanted filigree, but I could not find wood filigrees or plaster filigrees, for free. So I ended up making this. So it's going to be really, once it's finished, I'm not actually going to take it off the thing. I have them already attached, some of them, but it's going to be pretty slick. So I'm double layering it on the in, and then on that, and then swirling on the inside. Just another way to go. And this is the Pompeii alabaster. Pink alabaster Pompeii. That's where I'm at. All right.